fundamental pillars.
Right, this is my programme on RT News, it's called Watching the Hawks. This guy here, I don't know if he's a shapeshifter or not, but the sides of his head are green. I don't know if it's anything to do with green screen, I don't know. But he's got dodgy teeth as well. Just have a fucking look at this guy, man. Look at the sides of his head. He goes green all the time. His fucking face changes colour as well all the time, man.
The U.S. drone assassination program is the judge, jury, and executioner in the U.S. war on terror, even if you're a U.S. citizen. Yes, the United States government has on purpose, not by accident, actively killed its own citizens overseas by drone strike. So, what is a citizen to do if they suddenly find themselves on a U.S. kill list after having already been targeted at least five different occasions? That is the question posed in a recent Rolling Stone article by award-winning journalist Matt Taibbi, who I sat down with earlier today here in New York City to talk about the important case of Bilal Abdul Karim, an American citizen and controversial journalist in Syria who believes he is on the U.S. drone assassination kill list and is now suing the U.S. government. I started by asking Matt what drew him to this incredible story.